Okay, now it is visible. Yes. Yes, student, now it is visible or not?
Yes, ma'am, visible.
Okay. Actually, in 2015, we were there at SCRT for one certificate course, and certificate course was regarding audio visual aids. Okay, and that certificate course was of 21 days, no holiday in between. We have to continue the course, join for the first from the first day, and it will end at 21st day. There is no weekly off, there is no holiday, nothing. Okay, and basically these courses they are taking during the vacations, or most of the times, for example, we are not having admissions during the May month or in the month of June. So during such period, they are taking such kind of certificate courses. Okay. And who are enrolling that courses? So here the primary teachers, secondary teachers, and the teacher educators, they are enrolling for that courses. And the course was related to audio visual aids, because you know, there is a, as a teacher, we should use audio visual aids and for the effective teaching learning process. Okay, so I'm just going to tell you what we have learned, because I have some videos regarding that. Okay, so I think we should start with see, as a teacher, we have to prepare the teaching aid, and the teaching aid should be colorful. So within short period of time, how to prepare a teaching aid? So that concept we got from SCRT, and the division was the teaching, what is the audio visual aids section was there. You can able to see this video? Yes. Yes, students.
Yes, ma'am.
See how our teacher, and he is Tupay sir, and how he is making scenery by using. So what he is using? He is using cotton, color, and water. And within less time, he is going to make the scenery, entire scenery. See how he is going to prepare. This will help you in your career also. I'm going to click on the next video. So first part is done. Now this is the second part. He is taking the center. Okay. What is the center of that paper? See what he is doing with the help of cotton only. He is doing everything with the help of cotton. See, most of the time you are using the same color to give you the color to give color wash for the paper while drawing anything, any scenery or any kind of picture. See, again with the help of same, that is the cotton. These are the some clues how you can draw the picture by using cotton. I'm just moving the forward video. This is the part two, we can say. Then I'm going to click on the third. See, by using cotton also, this is the water. Now you can able to see the trees. And now he is using
Yes,
brush.
ma'am.
Yes, now he's yes, now he's using brush. I'm going to forward this. Okay. See, this is the picture. This is the last video. Think within hardly 15 minutes, he has drawn the this beautiful scenery. एंड स्टार्टिंग में हमने रिकॉग्नाइज नहीं किया था कि एक्चुअली ये ड्रॉ क्या कर रहा है, लेकिन बाद में समझ में आया कि ये एक्चुअली क्या सीनरी वो ड्रॉ कर रहा है. ओके, दिस इज द वन थिंग वी लर्न एट एस सी आर टी. ओके, देन Do you want to see me in the another getup, in the getup of Adivasi? So there is one video. I'm just going to remove my pins of my phone, so we'll get the audio also. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
And the audio of video is also audible.
Yes, ma'am.
I don't know whether you understand Marathi because the entire communication on the media of instruction was in Marathi. So you can see the different teachers. So these are the teacher educators. These seven were from MIT and the remaining teachers from the primary and secondary section were there. These Vagmare sir is going to make me colorful. You can hear the gossip between the teachers. Oh, this is me in the year 2015. You can see Rokhde, I think Rokhde ma'am, she is also there.
Yes, ma'am.
Actually, what sir was saying that, so whenever there is any special function for the children, at that time we can make them colorful. आप उनके फेसेस जो भी वो कलरफुल कर सकते हैं, उनको अलग गेटअप दे सकते हैं, वो बहुत ज्यादा खुश हो जाएंगे. तो ऐसे भी एक्टिविटी आप आपके स्कूल में रन कर सकते हैं. तो उन्होंने फेस कलरिंग कैसे किया जाता है, विच कलर वी सपोज टू यूज, ऐसे किया था. फाइनली मेरा गेटअप आप देखोगे तो फाइनली आई वॉज इन आदिवासी गेटअप, यू कैन सी And then finally, sir, he has changed the character, and lastly, I was in the Adivasi Gator. You can see me in the Adivasi Gator. I'm going to forward this video. The final touch up. You can see Rokhde ma'am here, she is with me. Okay. So, my voice is audible to you, yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
So this is about the face coloring. We learn about how to color the face whenever there is a special program regarding the related to the students. Then see, we also prepare the mask, and our the mentor, you can say our teachers, he gave us the task, and we supposed to perform the task in a group. So according to the characters, we supposed to prepare the mask. So these are the different kinds of masks we have made over there. You can see in the video.
Looks very lovely, ma'am.
Yes. Actually, we enjoyed a lot. We learned and we enjoyed also.
दोन तीन दिवस हा
And now we can, I'm going to show you the performance of the teachers by wearing these masks. Okay. It is written over here, Maharashtra as a Drupad Salvia. Drupad Salvia means audio visual. And it is me.
Good morning, my dear friends.
Good morning.
Do you like poem?
Yes.
You can see total, I think this is the group of 5 or 6 teachers, and he is the teacher, I think I remember his name, Vishwe sir, and within next 2 to 3 months he was going to retire, but see how he actually has participated in the activity. It is very nice experience we have. This is the heterogeneous group, some other teacher educators, some other secondary teachers, some other primary teachers.
My grandfather had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. My grandfather had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on the farm he had some dogs,
one performance, and the speciality of this performance was I was the only who was making all the voice noises, you can say. Jitne bhi characters yahan pe bataye hain, sabki awaazein maine nikali thi isme. And now I'm going to show you the another act, and it is Rokde ma'am. She has played that act. Do you understand Marathi? गोष्ट ऐकली होती ज्याच्यामध्ये म्हातारी लेकीकडे जाते, ती भोपळ्यामध्ये बसलेली असते. तर या ग्रुपने काय केलं होतं, ती गोष्ट ऍडव्हान्स केली होती, त्याच्यामध्ये चेंजेस केले होते, आणि त्यांनी वेगळ्या पद्धतीने ती गोष्ट परफॉर्म केली होती. आणि मास्क जे कॅरेक्टर जसे आहे, जसे की हे झाड आहे, दिस इज द ट्री, सो शी वेअर दिस मास्क ऑफ अ ट्री. ओके, तो ऐसे उन्होंने परफॉर्म किया था. सो लेट्स एंजॉय दिस एक्ट.
कविता है She was the old lady. You want to see this video? You have to continue this video. Are getting bored? Yes.
No, ma'am. Interesting all.
Okay. Do you recognize the person? Just now she came.
No, ma'am.
She is Rokde, ma'am.
The main character of Rokde, brown color dress. Others we don't know, ma'am. Brown color dress.
That's the reason. See, others are also. She's Jyoti Tekari. She is from Kothur. She is also teacher educator. But I'm only telling the names of the person who knows you. You know
yes.
them.
Yes.
Okay? So here is the Rokde, ma'am. She is playing role of a.
I'm gonna
Enjoyed this act? Yes. Yes, students.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So apart from this, we also learned how to make a movie. So that was our first experience. And I'm just going to show you that movie. Date, it's in 2014 in the month of July. These are the list of the teachers.
Stationary, while the birds are flying, car is moving, and an aeroplane is flying in the sky. These objects are moving, so they are said to be in motion. Let us learn motion and types of motion. What is motion?
We have selected this topic. Hello. We have selected this topic for video making, and so whatever software they told us, we use the same software, and so many parts are there, how to train the videos, how to take the particular part of the videos, how to do motion to the particular images. So we learn a lot of things over there. And the specialty of this video is that everyone is participated while making this video. You see, every teacher, the primary teacher, secondary teacher, actually we were from the DEd course. That means we were the teacher educator. So we have selected this topic. And they were not used to the English language. But still, they participated while making this video. And everyone has given the voice, his own voice or her own voice for making this video. So initially, it was my voice. Whatever voice you heard now, right now, it was my voice. And later on, in between, the other group members, they are also given their voices. And the proper recording, so audio one, audio two, like that. So proper audio recording were there, then you prepared the, we added the movie videos and the pictures, we gave the animation effect, and at the particular place we added the audios, and according to audios we did the settings, okay. And the, this is the final output, and this is the small video on the topic motion. Just enjoy this video.
An object changes its place with respect to any other stationary object, it is said to be in motion.
The train is in motion with respect to a boy. Every object moves with a different kind of motion. The first type of motion is linear motion. Linear motion, a motion in only one direction, is called linear motion. For example, bullock cart and line of ants. A bullock cart moves slowly in one direction and in one line. It is said to be in linear motion. The line of ants is in linear motion. A linear motion can be uniform linear motion and non-uniform linear motion.
Uniform linear motion, a motion in which a specific distance is being covered in particular period, is called uniform linear motion.
When soldiers march in a parade, each one has exactly the same kind of motion. This is uniform motion. When the motion is linear but not in the uniform motion, it is called non-uniform linear motion. For example, while coming back to school, you may run or walk with different movement and with different speed. The other kind of motion is oscillatory motion.
Oscillatory motion, a to and fro repetitive motion, is called oscillatory motion.
The initial voice was Rokhri ma'am's voice, and the later on one sir was there, and he was not used to of English. वो एक sentence भी English नहीं बोल सकते, but यहाँ पे group का participation था, but repeatedly he was, जैसे हम लोग बोलते ना एक एक ही sentence बार बार repeat करते हैं उसको रटते हैं, वैसे ही वो सर कर रहे थे. उनको इतना ही रोड था to and fro movement, इतना ही उनको बोलना था, लेकिन वो बोलते ना एक actually वो जो करने की इच्छा होना, क्योंकि उनका वो एरिया नहीं है, टोटली मराठी, उनका इंग्लिश से कोई लेन देन नहीं है, लेकिन फिर भी उन्होंने, और एज देखा जाएगा तो आई थिंक प्लस 50 एंड स्टिल ही ट्राइड. सो वी हैव डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस ओवर देयर.
सी दिस स्विंग, इट मूव्स फ्रॉम वन एक्सट्रीम पोजीशन टू अनदर एंड बैक अगेन. इट टेक्स द सेम टाइम फॉर एवरी सच कंप्लीट स्विंग. वन कंप्लीट स्विंग इज कॉल्ड एन ऑसिलेशन. The movement of bird's wings, pendulum of clock, needle of a sewing machine are some of the other examples of oscillatory motion. The next type of motion is periodic motion.
Periodic motion. When a moving object passes through a certain point at regular intervals of time, its motion is called periodic motion.
Children, watch the motion of hands of a clock carefully. The minute hand completes one round in 60 minutes every time. Such regular motion is called periodic motion. The movement of trapeze artist in a circus is also an example of periodic motion. The motion of earth around the sun and that of the moon around the earth are also instances of periodic motion. The next type of motion is random motion. Random motion, a motion whose direction changes continuously, it's called random motion. See the beautiful butterfly. It flits from one flower to another. Its motion has no definite direction. Such motion is called random motion. The next type of motion is called circular motion.
Circular motion. The motion along a circle is called circular motion.
The movement of the blades of an electric fan and the turning of merry-go-round are some other examples of circular motion. So children, today we have learned that when an object changes its place with respect to any other stationary object, it is said to be in motion. Linear motion, uniform linear motion, non-uniform linear motion, oscillatory motion, periodic motion, random motion, and circular motion are various types of motion. Thank you.
Okay, this was the video on the topic motion we have prepared. Okay, so I think you got idea what kind of training we got over there. The training is regarding the mask making, training is regarding the different types of teaching aids. So, see, so many types of teaching aids. Let me just give you a small idea about the type of what kind of teaching aids. See. So this is a magic circle.
Dusra. आणि पहिला आणि या पहिल्या भागावरती तो तो विषय निवडलेला असेल त्या विषय
किंवा हियर यू कॅन सी
थ्री
डी पिक्चर यू कॅन सी हाउ टू प्रिपेअर थ्री डी पिक्चर
यूजिंग
द सेम पेपर You can see folding cards is such kind of teaching that you can also use while teaching in the classroom. So these are the folding cards. Actually, many camera teachers were there, so they have selected such kind of content. Okay, so many different kind of experience we have at SCRT during our certificate course. Okay, now let's move towards the you have idea about the SCRT, what kind of experience we have. Actually, today's lecture, if you see the time, it is quite big. So knowingly, I showed you this video, so you will get idea about the SCRT, actually how it is working for the teachers. This is a big portion of SCRT functioning. Okay, now we are going on the SCRT website, so you will get idea about the SCRT. Can anyone tell me the full form of SCRT? Yes.
Yes, ma'am. State Education of Counseling Research and Center.
Yes. Education of
you enjoyed the videos, let me know. Are you all getting bored?
Yes, yes, ma'am. Yes, yes, ma'am. We are enjoying. Yes,
enjoying. Okay, thank you. Okay, now I'm going to share the website. See, don't type only SCRT. You're supposed to type SCRT Maharashtra because this is a state level agency. We have studied about the NCERT and this is the SCRT. Just replace national word with the state word. Okay, so this is the State Council of Educational Research and Training. Okay, it is here.
Yes, ma'am. Yesterday you told.
So yes.
Do it.
Yes.
The See?
Now, yes. Just I don't know about the Maharashtra, what to say about the Maharashtra. Still, I'm Maharashtrian, and we are Maharashtrian because now you are in Maharashtra. But see, when we open the web page, I'm just going to compare both the website web pages. Just I'm going to yes, NCERT. Okay, screen is visible to you. Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
See yes, ma'am.
See the web page of NCERT. So whenever why there should be web page is it should tell about the particular agency, about the particular organization. So whatever it is, it may be institution, it may be organization, it may be agency, whatever it is. So the basic the functions, what functions they are. They are going to carry. So we should get idea about the entire the administrative setup about the work of that particular council. So if we see, so here we got clear idea about the what exactly NCERT, what it stands for, what are the main functions of this, what are the different constituents and departments of NCERT. Now see about the SCERT. On the SCERT page, it's in Marathi as it is in Maharashtra. I think the English version it is also available, but right now I'm not able to see that version. See, I'm going to click on the button, the tab, we can say about us. Okay, see about us, and you can see Amachi Prerana. Then there is a Shalay Shikshan Vibhag Mantri Varsha Gaikwad. What should be there about us? What they have displayed about our motivation. Okay, so I don't know the mentality of Maharashtra, those who are working on this particular thing. Okay, so SCERT. So do you have any idea or have you studied about something about the SCERT? Yes. So let's have a small discussion on this topic.
Yes, ma'am, yesterday you told, so I've gone through the web page of this. Okay. So the center of this is situated in Sadashivpet, Pune.
Yes, it is in Pune. See, yes. This is the SCERT. It is in every state. Okay, but if you are talking about the SCERT at the Maharashtra, so there is another name for SCERT, that is MSCERT. So that question can be asked in your final or in your prelim examination. Okay, so what is the another name for the SCERT in Maharashtra? So that can be MSCERT. That is MSCERT. Okay, so when it is established, yes.
Ma'am, it was I think 1963-64, 31st January.
Yes, it is.
Yes, ma'am. Director of Mr. N.K. Jarak.
Okay.
Right now.
Okay.
And the main function of this, I've gone through that like ma'am, last year also when the pandemic situation came, so they come to the guideline that there's is a reduction of syllabus from class first to eighth. They are focusing more in elementary school also.
Yes. Okay. Anything else?
And ma'am, also they include means they follow the various agency like NCERT, NCTE. They include this their guideline as well.
Actually, see, because there should be coordination between the different agency, because we learned that HRD ministry is the topest, what you can say, the topest body in the field of education. And this NCERT, the function of NCERT, it assists the Ministry of HRD, that is Human Resource Development. And see, the same, that is the difference between NCERT and SCERT, that is the central level council and this is the state level council. Okay, so of course there should be coordination between, and if we see, so this is the Rajya Shaikshanik Sanshodhan Prashikshan Parishad Maharashtra. So the function of this particular agency, it is reflected in the name. So educational research and the prashikshan, it means the training, and again it work for the publications and the extension services. Okay, so if we see the initial name, of course this MSCERT, or we can say the SCERT in Maharashtra, it is established in the year 1964-65. And if we see the initial name of this institution, that is State Institute of Education. Please remember this name, because again there may be possibility to ask the MCQ type question based on this. So another name for this MSCERT. See, MSCERT, because, or we can say the SCERT in Maharashtra. Okay, because this is the state level agency and it is in every state. Okay, so there is a renaming of this agency, because the initial name when it was established, that was the State Institute of Education, and it is renamed in 1984. So it is easy to remember, because it established in 64-65, and there is a renaming for the this agency, or you can say the council, that is in the year 1984, means approximately the 20 years gap was there. Okay, and basically this stands for improving the quality of school education. Okay, and it is taking responsibility of the teacher education, research and evaluation. Okay, so this is the state level supportive agency. If we see, always remember four things about this agency. The first is research in education. So we'll capture this word, that is research in education, or you can say Shaikshanik Sanshodhan, research in education. The second is training. So this particularly SCERT, it is given training for the in-service teachers, not for the pre-service teachers. So whenever the training words came here, it is related to the in-service training. So first thing is the research in education, or you can say the educational research. The second is in-service training. The third is extension work, and the last is publication. Okay, so these four things are very important regarding this MSCERT. If we see, I'm going to click on the departments, and see why I'm showing this website, because if you are getting information from the other books, so there, if you see the numbers, I saw the book for this SCERT, so the total number of departments, see how many departments are here, just let's count. See, 5 into 4, total 20 departments are here. Okay, and we were did certification course from this department, that is audio visual education. Okay, so total 20 departments, but the books, in the books the number, it is very less. Somewhere it is 10, somewhere it is 16. Okay, so you will get updated information on the websites also. So that's why I'm showing you the website. So total they are having 20 departments. Okay, and you can see the work of each department here. Okay, research section. See, again you can see about the action research, means here they are focusing on the action research, and the aim is to train the teachers from primary and secondary schools in the methods of educational action research. Okay, so this is them, they are focusing on the action research. Now tell me, do you find any difference? There are different kinds of research, I think you have studied those types, yes or no? Do you don't have any idea? Because I think you have did one action research in this year also, right? Yes,
yes ma'am.
So what do you mean by action research?
You work on a problem, mm-hmm, and find a solution for it.
Yes,
the
yes, that is nothing but the actually, basically there are the three types of research: fundamental research, then second is the, I think the application research. The third is the action research. And the fundamental literature means whatever theories, the principles we are studying, that is the fundamental research. And whatever research for the PhD level, for the MED level, that comes under the second category. And the third category, that is nothing but the action research. Okay. The second is the application research, we can say. And third is the action research. So, because in the second category, it is applicable. So, whatever findings are there, it is applicable by others also. And in the third category, the particular teacher is having particular problem. So, the particular teacher only is working at that problem and he is finding the solution. So, for that, he is doing the research. So, it comes under action research. And this SCRT mainly focuses on the action research. And apart from that, short researches, then research bulletins are also there. See, so you can write whenever you're going to write about the what are the different objectives of the SCRT. So you can write what your departments are there, and each department is having its own objective. So to publish the research work in the field of education. So again, you can see here the publication. So there is the connectivity between the different whatever four things we saw before, there is connectivity between that also. Okay. Annual reports, so what they have published in the particular year, the particular department. So these are, there are total 20 departments, and they have to present the annual reports. And here the objective and the objectives are, total three objectives are there. Okay, so this is the work of the particular department. Okay. Then extension section, this is very important because as I told you, I have to focus on the four words, the research in education, the second is in-service training, third is extension work, and fourth is the publication. Okay. The information is basic information, so when this particular section is established, okay, and what is the main aim of this particular section or department, we can say, to develop primary and secondary teachers' quality. Especially section works to know the new aspect and techniques in education at everywhere. Okay, so extension services they are providing. Basically, it moves around the teaching learning process about the evaluation. See, you can see to enhance the process of teaching learning, to motivate new educational concepts. So whatever new trends and new techniques they are emerging in the education field. So they are here, this extension section, they are arranging different seminars, workshops, or we can say the conferences for the teachers at primary and secondary level. And there are different extension centers, and the programs are going to conduct at the different extension centers and the schools in the vicinity. The primary teachers and secondary teachers in the vicinity schools, they are going in that particular extension center, and they are taking training in that. See the connectivity. Research, publication. Initially, we saw the connectivity between research and publication, and here the extension and the training session. And we are talking about the in-service training only. So here, these are the different objectives of this particular section, we can see. Then the publication section, I'm just knowingly I'm going to click on the certain sections only. You will get more information by clicking other sections also, but main focus should be given on these four parts. Okay, this is the publication section. To render guidance to primary school teachers considering their needs and difficulties in day-to-day teaching through Jeevan Shikshan and other publications. So you'll get information that this particular agency, or you can say council, they are going to publish one magazine, and name of the magazine is Jeevan Shikshan, and they are also having other publications. We'll come to know more about in the publication tab. Even the another task, see, whenever I'm telling you that, so whenever you're going to click on the particular departments, you will come to know about the function of that particular department. So here, whenever you are going to write different functions, just take one function of the particular department and write it. Okay, and the objectives, you can just convert objective into functions and functions into, you have to just reframe the sentence, that's it. Okay, so here again, not only the publication, but the production and the distribution of the Jeevan Shikshan. So that is also one task this particular section is having. And see the other publications, Atvanitil Shara Ani Shikshak, yes. Then Maza Vegra Upakram, Prashna Manjusha, and RT 2019. These are the other publications. So in publication, see, I'm telling you, please go to the website, because in MCQs, they will ask about the publications. Okay, out of the following is not the publication of SCERT. And here you have to find out the answer. So please see this very carefully. Then the other department. See, evaluation, research is there. Okay, State Board of Teacher Education, curriculum development. So many departments are there. Okay, just go through it and don't touch other departments, but mainly focus should be on this. Research, extension, publication, evaluation. Okay, some of these departments. And total 20 departments are here for the smoothly functioning of the SCERT. Okay, then the diet. This is very important. District Institute for Educational Training, Education and Training. So diet, you can see there are different diets at district wise. See, and it is under SCERT. See, there is a hierarchy. So diet rate comes under SCERT. So we can say the for diet, the SCERT is the higher authorized agency. Okay, here you can see the downloads, and in the downloads they are given the syllabus. I'm going to click on the syllabus, and in the syllabus you can see Bhasha Bhag 1, Bhasha Bhag 2, Bhashetar Bhag. The syllabus is given over there. It is for the teachers. Okay, now I'm going to click on the Jeevan Shikshan. So whenever you will get time, just go on this SCERT website. And if you know the Marathi, because the Jeevan Shikshan magazine, it is in Marathi language only. And their publication, the publication of SCERT. I'm just going to click on this. See. You can see very beautiful magazine here. And various articles are written by the teachers or the teacher educators, primary or secondary teachers, and the teacher educators. And there is a, what we can say, there is a committee. We're going to moderate the articles written by the teachers. And after getting the confirmation, then they can publish the article in the magazine, Jeevan Shikshan. See, here the magazine, it is available free of cost. You can just take it from website. See, one more thing, this is the Prashnapedi. Prashnapedi means question bank. So they are also making available question bank. See, question bank for 10th and 12th standard. And again, they are given the medium also. They are giving the question bank for the students of Marathi medium and English medium as well. And apart from that, they are also taking care of the Urdu medium. Okay, so you can see the different subjects here, and they are giving the question bank for the student. I think many parents, they are not aware about this. Okay. Marathi Madhyam Shaikshanik Dindarshika. It is year wise. See, it is from first standard to 10th standard. And if you see the year, it is not year wise. I think it is quarterly, from December 2020 to April. Means it is quarterly. They are going to publish this Shaikshanik Dinadarshika. Okay, you will get much more information from the website, but my request is for more give more focus on the what are the objectives of this website, not this particular council, what are the functions of this particular council, and what are the different departments. Okay, just you can get objectives and functions after clicking the department. Okay, and just focus on the publication, training, research and extension work only. And apart from that, you may they may ask questions about the Jeevan Shikshan. So the following, which agency is Jeevan Shikshan magazine is publicated by which agency? So such kind of questions they will ask. So you should know about this also. Okay, about the publications, whether they are going to publish this. This is the annual magazine or this is the quarterly magazine. You should know about this. Okay. See, you can see April, May, June means this is the monthly magazine. This is not quarterly, this is annually, but this is the monthly magazine. Okay, so this is the information about the SCERT. Okay, understood about the SCERT? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, just yes, focus ma'am. On the whatever. Okay, are you getting bored? Yes or not?
No, ma'am.
No. Ma'am. Okay. Ma'am. Yes.
The video you shown, ma'am. It yes. was. In training program of that government body.
It was in service. Yes, it is in service. See, SCERT.
Ma'am, you have prepared for it a lot. Like, how many days you give for preparation for this all, ma'am?
For what?
Actually, what? Means, ma'am, every coordination between you and other people and like,
एक्चुअली द थिंग वॉज ना कि हम जब एस सी आर टी में थे उनका टाइमिंग क्या था पता है आपको 9:30 से लेके 6 o'clock एंड इन बिटवीन ओनली वी आर हैविंग 45 minutes लंच ब्रेक एंड आई थिंक इन बिटवीन 10 minutes स्मॉल रिसेस वॉज देयर तो वहाँ पे स्टार्टिंग में क्या था 7 डेज तो टोटल 21 डेज का था तो स्टार्टिंग में हमें बताया था कि ऑडियो विजुअल मतलब कलरिंग वगैरह ड्रॉ कैसे करना है वो हमें 7 डेज का ट्रेनिंग था उसके नेक्स्ट वो हमने हमारा लिया था तूपे सर ने उसके बाद नेक्स्ट जो लिया था वो वाघभारे सर थे उन्होंने हमें बताया था कि अलग अलग टीचिंग एड जो मैंने आपको बताया मैजिक फोल्डर्स मैजिक सर्कल मैजिक फ्लावर तो हर एक डे पे अलग था और उसी डे पे हमें वो वही करना था अगर आपका पेंडिंग वहां पे रह गया तो आपका तो वो एज अ होमवर्क आपको करना ही था ठीक है और लास्ट का जो 7 डेज का था उसमें मेन था मूवी मेकिंग तो उसके लिए एक्चुअली क्या होता था कि वो टाइम पे मतलब 2014 की बात है वो टाइम पे ज्यादा डिवाइसेस हमारे पास नहीं थे इंटरनेट फैसिलिटी नहीं थी तो उसमें सबसे ज्यादा मेहनत तो मैंने ही ली है क्योंकि वो वही टारगेट होता है जिसके पास वो एक्सेसरीज हाँ अवेलेबल है तो एक्चुअली तभी नहीं आज भी मैं ही सफर करती हूँ क्योंकि जब भी हम आपने भी एक्सपीरियंस किया रहेगा कि जब भी कोई ग्रुप वर्क रहता है तो जो लीड करता है उसी के ऊपर ज्यादा रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी आ जाती है ऑटोमेटिकली होता है और हमारे यहाँ पे क्या था कि हेट्रोजीनियस ग्रुप था वहाँ पे प्राइमरी टीचर्स थे सेकेंडरी टीचर्स थे तो उनका एक बोलते ना एक व्यू एक हर एक चीज को देखने का एक नजरिया रहता है वो अलग था हमारा अलग था और हमारा हम शायद MIT से 7 या 8 लोग हम MIT से थे लेकिन वो हमेशा वो ग्रुप कैसे बनाते थे जस्ट टेल 1 2 3 4 5 कभी कभी सब 1 को ऐड कर दिया 5 को ऐड कर दिया ऐसे करते थे नहीं तो एक 1 to 5 का एक ग्रुप 1 to 5 का दूसरा ऐसे बनाते थे और हमें इतना कम समय मतलब हमें स्क्रिप्ट भी खुद को लिखना है हमें उसके लिए तैयार भी करनी है हमें प्रिपरेशन भी करना है और हमें प्रेजेंट भी करना है ठीक है तो ये और बहुत अच्छा एक्सपीरियंस था क्योंकि वहां पे कुछ ऐसे थे कि जैसे कि विश्व सर है 2 महीने में वो रिटायर होने वाले थे लेकिन स्टिल और वो एक वो ड्राइंग टीचर थे तो हम वो हमारे ग्रुप में थे तो हमारे लिए वो मास्क मेकिंग वगैरह बहुत इजी था हमने वहां पे जैसे हम टास्क डिवाइड करते वैसे हमने किया था तो एक अलग एक्सपीरियंस था तो आपको ये बताने का ये है कि और ये सबसे बड़ी बात है कि हमने वो सर जो भी टीचिंग है जिन्होंने सिखाए थे हमने उनको बुलाया भी था हमारे कॉलेज में हमने कंटिन्यूसली 2 ईयर्स हमने वर्कशॉप लिया था और उसके बाद कंटिन्यूसली 2 ईयर्स रोकड़े मैम और मैंने हम दोनों ने मिलकर वर्कशॉप लिया था और टोटल डे हमने 1 डे और 2 डे हमने वर्कशॉप लिया था तो बच्चों को भी आइडिया आ गया कि अलग अलग अभी क्या हो रहा है कि पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन की वजह से ये पॉसिबल नहीं हो पा रहा है, लेकिन हमें भी वो अच्छा, क्योंकि थोड़ा सा किसी हम भूल जाते हैं बाद में, फिर वो नोटबुक निकालो कैसे मेजरमेंट्स लेने हैं क्या करना है वो देखने के बाद तो समझ में आता है। और डेफिनेटली अगर हमें टाइम मिलता है तो सही में हम आपके लिए वैसे एक वर्कशॉप ऑर्गेनाइज करेंगे, अच्छा लगेगा हमें वैसे करने को। एक बहुत अच्छा एक्सपीरियंस था। हाँ, और जो हमने ट्रेनिंग की बात मैं आप बताती हूँ, जो हमने इस ये पैनासोनिक और ये था सर्व शिक्षा अभियान के अंतर्गत हमने ट्रेनिंग लिया था, मैंने कल भी बताया था कि सातारा डिस्ट्रिक्ट में लिया था, और उसमें उसमें तो एक ही टीचर को होल डे, मतलब 10:30 को आपका स्टार्ट होगा और 5:30 को आपका फिनिश होगा, सो एंटायर डे सेम टीचर। और वो ग्रुप किसका था, वहां पे ग्रुप था प्राइमरी एंड सेकेंडरी टीचर्स का, और एक इसमें 50-60 स्टूडेंट्स थे और उनको हमें सिखाना था। एक्चुअली उनको देखा जाएंगे तो वो 20-30 इयर्स का एक्सपीरियंस टीचर थे, और जब हम गए थे तो हमें देखने के बाद उनको ऐसे लगता भी नहीं था कि अरे ये हमें क्या सिखाएंगे। और मेरे साथ तो मैंने किया था, मेरे साथ तो दो स्टूडेंट्स थे, क्योंकि हम सबसे पहले हम कराड़ में गए थे, कराड़ में जाने के बाद हमें पता चला कि दो सेंटर्स है, तो बाहर जाने के लिए दूर जाने के लिए कोई तैयार नहीं था। और हमारे साथ एज अ टीचर ट्रेनी एज अ ट्रेनर हमने दो स्टूडेंट्स लिए हुए थे, दो बॉयज थे, और फिर ऐसे हो गया कि तीन लोगों को बाहर जाना है, वो तीन लोग कौन जाएंगे, तो स्टूडेंट्स ही बोले कि मैम हम चले जाते हैं। अभी वहां पे सवाल यह था कि हम दिखने में सब ऐसे ही, मतलब जो बोलते ना थोड़ा सा सीनियर दिखना चाहिए वैसे रहेगा तो थोड़ा उसका एक इम्पैक्ट अलग पड़ता है, सामने वाला थोड़ा सा सीरियसली देखता है, तो हम लोगों को देखने के बाद ऐसे होगा कि अरे क्या होगा। लेकिन वहां जाने के बाद बहुत ही अच्छा एक्सपीरियंस था, और जैसे कि क्या होता है जैसे आप डिलीवर करते हो ना उनको इंटरेस्ट, लेकिन वो एक ही था कि उनको पूरा मराठी में बोलना था, वहां पे एंटायर थिंग इज वॉज इन मराठी, तो वो एक अलग एक्सपीरियंस था। क्योंकि जब भी आपको अलग लैंग्वेज की आदत हो जाती है तो कंटिन्यूसली उसमें एक ही लैंग्वेज में बोलना, कि वो जो ठीक है मानती हूँ मैं महाराष्ट्रियन हूँ मराठी हूँ, लेकिन वो वर्ड्स आपको याद नहीं आते क्योंकि आपने बहुत सालों से उसको यूज नहीं किया है, ठीक है, तो वैसे होता था। लेकिन बहुत एंजॉय किया था वहां हमने, और कंटिन्यूसली 3 डेज का वो ट्रेनिंग था, और उसमें हमने कंस्ट्रक्टिविज्म के ऊपर फोकस किया था, वैगोर्स्की का जो सोशल डेवलपमेंट का जो थ्योरी है उसके ऊपर हमने फोकस किया था, रिवाइज्ड ब्लूम टैक्सोनॉमी पे फोकस किया था, और बहुत ही बढ़िया एक्सपीरियंस था वो। तो मैं आपको ये कहना चाहती हूँ कि ठीक है अभी बीएड हो जाने के बाद जहाँ जहाँ पे आपको अपॉर्चुनिटी मिले, भले वो आपका इंस्टीट्यूशनल ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम हो, बाहर का कहीं हो, आप सर्च करो, आप एससीईआरटी के प्रोग्राम में भी आप ज्वाइन हो सकते हो। आप वेबसाइट पे जाओ, वहाँ पे कॉन्टैक्ट्स में कुछ आपको नंबर्स मिलते हैं, कम्युनिकेट करो और कुछ अलग लर्न करने की कोशिश करो।